Hi there, my name is Dr. Sara Barton. I'm one of the reproductive endocrinologists at the Colorado Center for Reproductive Medicine in Denver, Colorado. Today, I'm going to cover the topic of gamete donation or third-party reproduction with donor sperm. And in a subsequent video, I'll talk more about egg donation. There are a lot of reasons why people present to a fertility clinic needing a donor sperm. Sometimes this is known when the patient presents because they might be a single patient or in a same-sex or transgender relationship. In other cases, people present with infertility and a significant male factor infertility is diagnosed that requires the use of a sperm donor. We do offer services with sperm donation at CCRM. This is a process that takes a little bit of advanced planning and timing, as do most fertility treatments. So if this is a treatment that you are considering and you think you might wish to pursue pregnancy within the next 6 months, I would encourage you to consult with a physician now to get the process started. Sperm donation typically involves some basic fertility evaluation for the recipient of that donation. For example, if a single woman is using a donor sperm, we want to understand if we have the option of both intrauterine insemination, IUI, or in vitro fertilization, IVF. This is going to depend on the age of the recipient, her fertility testing such as ovarian reserve, desired family size, as well as the status of the fallopian tubes. And these things are evaluated through blood test, ultrasound, and an X-ray. Specific to sperm donation, there are a few additional evaluations that need to be performed. The first is a meeting with a counselor to discuss the issues of third-party reproduction for offspring. This is not an evaluation to see if you're fit to be parents. This is an evaluation that provides you the opportunity to learn about what we've learned over the years through the offspring of third-party reproduction or donation, the issues that might arise with curiosity as those children get older, and selection issues regarding selection of a donor and the limits of anonymity. This is recommended by the American Society for Reproductive Medicine, and we fully support this practice. We do have in Colorado licensed therapists to meet with you specific to the issues about third-party reproduction with donor sperm. Finally, you need to go through a process of selecting a donor. Donors can either be anonymous or someone that you know. At CCRM Colorado, we do offer what's called directed sperm donation, which means you bring someone to you that you wish to be your donor, and we complete the FDA screening process that is required for that donor. It is also very common to use an anonymous donor through a sperm bank. We are not a sperm bank, but we work with sperm banks to have the donor sperm shipped from a sperm bank to CCRM. There is a very strict guideline set out by the FDA that guides the process of sperm donation in regards to infectious disease testing. Additionally, it is recommended that sperm donors undergo genetic screening to see if they are healthy, silent carriers of a recessive condition. Just to think back for a moment about high school biology, if you remember recessive and dominant diseases, recessive diseases are often silent in the people who carry them because you have two copies of those genes. And in a recessive disease, both copies would need to be abnormal to cause disease. So many of us carry recessive conditions that we don't know about. This becomes relevant when you're reproducing because if your donor or husband or partner were to carry the same illness, then your baby would have a 1 in 4 or a 25% chance of being sick with that illness. So donors go through a process of genetic carrier screening, and if they carry a recessive condition, we want to make sure the recipient of that donation or the egg source undergoes screening to make sure they don't carry the same disease and that those risks are not present to the offspring. The final thing to know about with sperm donation is that there's infectious disease screening for the donor and the recipient of the donation as outlined by the FDA. One disease that's very important is called CMV. CMV stands for cytomegalovirus. It's a viral infection that's very common in our environment, and many of us have already been exposed to CMV. After an initial exposure, your body will create antibodies that protect you against a severe form of CMV that can be developed in a neonate if you're exposed for the first time to CMV during a pregnancy. Donors are also screened for CMV. If your donor is CMV positive, meaning a history of exposure to CMV, we ask you to select to be CMV positive as well. If you are CMV negative, meaning you've never had exposure and have no immunity to CMV, it is safer for you to pick a donor who is CMV negative. So just to recap, when you're thinking about using a donor sperm for whatever the indication, there's fertility evaluation, selection of the donor, paying attention to genetic carrier screening and infectious disease screening, and meeting with a counselor. Once that donor sperm is selected, it can be shipped to CCRM for use in care with either IUI or IVF. Obviously, your individual treatment plan would be determined based on your family goals, your personal medical and reproductive history, your age, and your fertility testing. Because this process can take several months, during this downtime that we are all forced in with COVID-19, I would encourage you to reach out to a physician now and start those conversations so that when these restrictions are lifted, much of that work has been completed and you can move along to building your family goals. Have a great day.